back to our regular meeting on 11/6/19 at the last.
I'll make a motion that we approve all three sets of minutes.
Can you do them all at once? I don't know.
Yes, we can. Can't we, Pat? You don't care, do you?
As long as I keep up the writing.
All right. All of them? Mm-hmm. That'll be 11/6/19.
Okay, what you have is got the minutes from 11/6.
12/17/19.
And you got minutes from 12/2, which is a special fireboard, special meeting, and 12/17.
Yes.
I'm looking this way, I'm Terry shaking this out, you ready? All in favor?
Yes.
Opposed? Okay, all the minutes were passed. Bills?
Shirley's running about 5 minutes late.
We have a copy of the bills.
Yeah, we got a copy. Did you have a copy, Terry?
Yes.
Go look at mine, you got one, I might have to do one. So coming sales. Well, coming sales, is that where we took the truck that was towed, 16? And that's all better now?
Yep. Just gonna be replacing the tires on. They have to be either torn down or replaced every 10 years.
I don't see coming sales.
I have a question.
Oh, yeah.
Is there a problem with the public getting a copy of the bills? Being put out?
No, and if you want a copy, you can come get mine, because it's on the internet, and I'll get, make you a copy if you want one every month.
I would like it.
Okay, just remind me.
We usually get them the day of the meeting.
Yeah.
Huh?
We usually get them the day of the meeting or the day before the meeting.
Yeah, and she emails them to me. And what I'll do is when I make a copy for him, I'll make you a copy.
Yeah.
All right, thank you.
Put it in your box.
It's just kinda hard to follow if you don't have something that is outside here sitting listening.
That's the software program. Do we have a motion on approval for the bills?
No, we're waiting for.
I'll make a motion for the bill.
Are we satisfied with that?
You can do whatever you want, I'm just making a motion.
Well, we're still working on it down here, Sharon.
Because we're supposed to make a motion for it, there's any discussion on the bill. I just wanna make sure we're right, you know?
Yeah, oh, yeah.
While you're waiting on that, can I have a question on the bills?
What's this thing, Michelle, single?
The public comment, you may.
Okay.
This one on what minutes? You put Jim Shelton?
Yeah.
You can ask Dave, he'll answer it.
Dave, where says Jim Shelton?
State reports, right?
Jim's been doing the state report.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, one time we had Terry come in and join him, and then she quit, and then that's during that transition between Sesniak and Beckman, and everybody getting reports done. Jim's doing that as a, he can't be on the fire department as a firefighter because of a disability from a car accident, so he's volunteered to do that.
Good.
We don't want them to be late, so that's a good thing.
Because then if those don't get done, you have to do them.
Huh?
It falls to the clerk.
I'm not a clerk.
I know.
Well.
Other than days I cook, you come sit here and do.
Yeah, I can pull my hair out.
Hey,
the towing bill, have we got reimbursed for the whole thing?
We got reimbursed from the towing bill from, which was the $222 that was towed from Second and M13 down to 16. And the bill we haven't got yet for the tow from 16 to Saginaw, which is $350.
Are we gonna put that in for insurance too?
I can't because that's not roads.
Yes, no.
I tried to get reimbursed for the tow from being stuck in the yard on Alameda Beach, and they can't, they couldn't pay for that.
What was our answer for that? Why didn't we pay for it?
It was off the road.
Off the road.
You said?
Yeah.
So Sharon's got a motion. I'll support it. Maybe Jordan support it. Pay the bills?
No, no, no.
Okay. Roll call vote?
Mark?
Yes.
Yes. Sharon?
Yes.
John?
Yes.
Gerald?
Yes.
Becky?
Becky.
Yes.
Is it Rebecca or Becky?
Rebecca, you like to call me.
Rebecca just sticks in my brain, so. Financial report?
All right, I'm still having problems with the AT&T. They finally have her bill correct. We went from $55 for each line in May to $117 in June to $137 in September. Now we're down to $85 in December. But they still have not adjusted, because I was not paying the full bill. I've only been paying what I felt would be the equivalent. That might be underpaid, but anyway, just so that you are aware, so I've gotten a notice for a shut-off notice, but I called them and they said, well, they'll talk with the person I talked with that was supposed to adjust the bill, and I think we're good. But it's just amazing.
Oh, okay, it's awful work with them, really, really is.
And then, that's it for the bill. I don't know where it comes in this situation. I need to know how am I going to handle getting these checks signed and back and forth. So I don't know if that's an agenda item or if that's something now.
I don't have a problem with you throwing them in the Dropbox, and then I come in early and I can sign them. I can bring them over there, or if you want him to sign, you let him know, and then he can come in and sign them, and then we'll bring them over there. Is that what you'd like?
Yeah, but we need to get him as a signer, because I feel bad for Mark, because.
He's not a signer?
Mark is.
Well, that's what I'm talking about.
Are you?
I don't have a problem. Monday or Tuesday's no problem for me.
That's a thing to line up a date for you, Joanna.
Huh?
Joanna, no.
Or I'll have him as a cosigner, and then there's three of us, in case I'm not here.
That would be awesome. So if you could give me on. I can't call you Gibby.
That's not your risk. Because Jason was.
Yeah, he was. And so you're in town more than Mark is, and then, yes, once both of you sign them, then sign them over.
Yeah, that's fine.
We're gonna sign, and then it's gonna be your responsibility to deliver it to wherever she needs it.
It just goes over there. That's fine, look, John will take care of that.
Okay.
All right, if that's what we're gonna be walking on, that works.
No, just put them on that desk, the radio desk, is that fine?
Radio desk is fine, or you can drop them into the report box that is locked.
Okay.
Probably would prefer it to be dropped into the report box.
Where's that at?
Right at the desk at the radio.
Okay.
There it says report. If you can drop it in there, because, and you also can.
That's fine.
Drop my mail off there, because a lot of times I used to come in at night, and with the locks changed, I don't have.
We can do that.
So do we need to make a motion to have Gibson become a cosigner?
Oh, yes. I make a motion that Gibby becomes a cosigner.
I'll second, I'll support the motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Oh, and also, I have to, I don't care if you guys care, but I have the W-2 still, I just have to
have the minutes, so she'll have to give you the minutes.
Oh, yeah.
Take to the bank, so he can be a signer.
And then do you have to give them some kind of signature authorization?
The minutes does it. So as long as he has the minutes for us, then he, we'll take it, we'll send it over to the bank.
Not just bank.
And it's back over here.
Is that it for the financial report?
Yes. Was that a comp call, the fire board call?
Yeah, fire board. Pinconning-Fraser Fire Board.
I'll make a motion to accept the financial report.
I support.
All in favor? Public comment.
Okay, now I guess I'll, I would like to question the Charter communication bill. Has anybody ever tried to negotiate with Charter? I just think, you know, looking at Charter, I think they're so high on their bills, and I've negotiated with my business, and I was just wondering, you know, sometimes we get lax at trying to do anything with these bills, and they come in, and I think, you know, that at least give a try to negotiate with them on the bill. Because I think Charter just keeps going up, and you know, I would love to see you at least try to get them negotiations. They worked with me at my laundromat, and I've got it brought back down. So I would love to see you at least try to get something brought up. But, you know, Charter's making some good money off all of us, and I think a lot of people just lax and just let it go. And I think they should go after them with it.
Have you talked to them, Shirley?
I have not, Charter.
Now, is that one of those things that's in Dave's name or your name?
Your name, I thought.
Township.
My name?
Because I tried before, they told me Sharon.
Because when all the phone numbers were changed and all that.
All right, we'll look into it.
Yeah, if you could. And then, you know, and it's up to you guys, but if you want to put my or Dave's name on there as an authorized to talk to them.
Okay.
That's up to you guys.
I thought Dave's name was on there.
I tried setting it up, and at that time, I was told that we were paying too much for the internet, and then everything went through the township, and that's when the phone number got changed and all that.
It must be in Joanna's name, I think. I'll look and see.
Any other public comment? Chief's report.
As you probably know, we've received the grant from the tribal of the 36,000, and we're in the process of getting the equipment ordered and everything taken care of.
How much, what was the total?
That's last meeting.
Oh, was it? Okay. Mm-hmm.
And then the firefighters, we've attended training at Mount Forest with Northern Bay Ambulance, and also had a couple at the continuing ed that Northern Bay put here on at the township was last 2 weekends. We had the Mavis meeting last night, and we discussed the
talking about the active shooter, Dave, do you know who taught the active shooter? Was that someone from around here who did it?
Who's teaching the active shooter?
Yeah.
We've had classes with MSP and also through Bay City and Police Department.
Okay.
So we've been doing that, Bay City Police Department.
Are they teaching Alice or are they teaching the other one?
The new one that they have, that they've developed. So they're teaching, they're going to Midland and teaching them. So Klein is the one that Kevin, and I think it's Kevin Klein that I, is the speaker. And they're looking, when we get into budgets, we're gonna be looking at trying to get, they need some funds for equipment, so.
Thank you.
That's all I have.
So any other questions for Dave?
I have one. I had a young lady contact me, wanting to join the fire department. You have a landline there? She says every time she calls, all she gets is a busy signal.
Probably because, yeah, I just have her give her my number or stop by and we can give her an application.
Well, that's what I text back to her, though. If you see somebody there, stop in, and when somebody's there, they'll take care of you.
I think we have some too in the front, in the file cabinet, that you could just walk in here. Various applications here.
And our.
We keep money in too.
But that does concern me if it's busy. One thing, if she called and doesn't get an answer, but if she's getting a busy, and I'm, what I'm just calling, maybe there's something.
Because it goes on the answering machine.
Does she call a new number?
Yeah, she's calling the old number.
Old number.
Maybe she's calling the old number.
Yeah, I have no idea what number she's calling.
Do you have her new number? I can email that to everybody, it's the new number.
Okay, yeah.
And one more question too, with Dave.
It rings in.
What's that?
It rings into the machine.
Yeah, so I'm thinking she might be calling that old number. But I will, I'll email that to everybody so you got it.
There was an application I handed in to you last month on.
He's got it, I just gave it to him.
Oh, you just gave it to him, oh, okay, I'm sorry, I thought we had it before, okay.
Wait your finger.
Can I ask you a question?
At the end of the day, I have a public comment.
Okay, it's just about what he said, so I was just.
Any other questions from the board for Dave? Okay. I'll make a motion to accept the chief's report.
I'll support it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Where are we at here? Unfinished business, I don't know if we wanted to set up more hearings, or we want to wait until after the budget season before we start talking about full-time fire discussion again, or what's the board feel on that one? I know we got budgets coming up, we're gonna talk about.
Well, I think that'd be a good time to talk about it.
During our budget workshop?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's fine. I'll add that, because that's all we have, because.
Okay.
You guys turned the budget, all you guys, what kind of budget did you give to us and then, yeah?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay. Because that's gonna be, you know, something we're gonna settle in.
Yeah, it's on your schedule he's got here, the fireman's schedule.
Okay, new business.
Motion to approve the schedule for 2020, January to 2021.
I'll support it. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Yeah, motion carried. You guys got copies, right? Of the schedule?
Yeah.
Okay.
When is the election?
Yeah.
March 10th, and I'm wondering about the 4th one, that's tomorrow.
And make a motion to accept the budget workshop is scheduled for March 4th.
Do you need to do that since we already adopted the schedule that's before?
Sure. I just wanted to make sure.
Okay.
Adding March 4th or November 4th is Wednesday.
What's that? It's a Wednesday.
You're thinking of elections on the Wednesday. Okay. Any announcements?
The budget or the meetings are going to be still be 6:30?
Yep.
Okay.
You can make it 6 if you want. I'm done going.
6:30 is fine. Well, we got all different times.
So confuse us.
All right.
Any announcements? Any more public comment?
Yes, again. I was just wondering, Dave, on that notification for people on the water, how are you getting the word out there for people about that they could call for help and find out who the handicap is?
That's what I was given the list of addresses. So we're trying to decide if we're going to go door to door, because we're doing this all the way from Hampton Township to the county line. So we're looking at handing out the Bay Alert things that 911 has. We're looking at doing door to door. We're looking at doing mailings. Cullen Township has already had a lady from Breesad Beach that took it upon herself to do all this, because we have two issues down there. One is the Breesad Beach is isolated by a swamp. So if that swamp ever catches on fire, those people will be trapped along the shoreline. Same way, so we're trying to get that taken care of, because the flag mites that's in that swamp through there, if they catch on fire, those people have no way of getting out but one road. So they can't go north or south, they have to come out. So we're trying to, that lady has helped a lot in Cullen. She's even got some on North Linwood Beach taken care of. So we're trying to figure out how to do it all together and notify the people. Well, one of the ways was probably if we do a newsletter through the townships to send out to do that, or it's just in the works. So we've never had, 1980 was the last ice that really came in bad, and because of the flood and that, and now with the water, they're anticipating the water will be up another 12 inches from what it is right now by spring. Our thing that is on our side right now is that the bay is not froze, so we have a lot of evaporation going on that's keeping the water level down. So if that freezes over from all this cold weather, then we got a problem, because it's not going to evaporate. And that's where we're at right now.
I'm very happy that you're working on it, because it is going to be a problem before the end of this season.
You know, we realize that some people will say we can't order them off, but we can tell them that they have to leave. Our other situation is that the evacuation centers in Bay City, from our discussion last night, 4 of them will be underwater. The middle grounds, all that, the community center, all that. So we have to filter out into the outer townships to do that. If we're occupied, the shoreline departments are occupied, then we have to do through Mavis, we have to then call townships like Auburn, Beaver, and those townships to move in and help us. Because see, Frankenless has on the middle ground, I don't know if you know where the middle grounds are in Bay City, the tip of the middle grounds to the south is Frankenless Township. It's not Bay City.
Yep. Is Aranac County involved in this game?
Aranac, we haven't discussed with them. They're pretty much, our system is just our chiefs have gotten together.
It's like, like Sandy Drive going north off of Bay Line Road, that's isolated.
Right. Those are all going to be.
Yeah, it's isolated way too. One way in, one way out.
And that, the waterfront, the things that people have put in to protect the shoreline front of their houses, and now they don't have that. So when this ice starts moving in, you know, I mean, you get a 3-4 foot sheet of ice, and the best way to describe it is like a deck of cards. A deck of cards just keeps sliding, and that's the way the ice keeps coming, so.
I know I got a resolution from Bangor Township Supervisor Glenn Rowley, and they want a resolution for the state issue of emergency.
But if we get into a situation, then each township has to do that, because with what we found out with FEMA in the past, is that if you have insurance, FEMA doesn't help you. FEMA only helps the people that don't have insurance. So those are the things that, you know, and that's why we updated the MABUS stuff, is so that we can bill for extra equipment that we may need, and that stuff, so we're covered if we have to have FEMA for that. So those are.
Yeah, we get those northeast winds, that's when we're in trouble.
I say I'm very happy with what you're working on it now, because it is gonna happen, there's no doubt about it.
Well, our big concern on Almeida Beach was the ditch to the north, because we could have lost.
Yes, that's a big ditch.
We could have lost engine 16 in the ditch, because what, was there 2 foot of water on that road?
The rescue was pretty much underwater.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The engine's all right, because that's diesel.
So, but if we drove off the roadway.
That one's a scary ditch.
That's a dream.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Johnson.
That's a cross.
Any other public comment? Sharon?
No, I'm ready to adjourn.
Well, let's make a motion.
I make a motion to adjourn.
I'll second it. All in favor?